I think the first land we want to get is probably just a basic. We want to preserve as much life as we can. Just going to cycle this now for the sake of F6ing. We've got all basics. We're light on cyclers, so that's definitely an issue. But we do have Outburst, and Treecko Maw seems pretty good as it will. Interesting that I played that Plains, but it seems fine. We're probably not going to want to Outburst next turn anyways. And this maybe masks that we have it. And if we need to Outburst, then we can use the Spirit Guide, but that is indeed a thing. All right, there's War Marshal, which is pretty annoying because it's going to get thrown to the bin. Interesting. I guess I could have played the Simian here, and I think maybe I should have. But nah, I think we're going to Living End pretty soon, and then we would want to hold. Okay, there goes that, but we're not taking very much damage, so. Unless there's. Okay, that's a fair amount of damage. 2, 4. Take all this. Get a stomping ground. You know, I just want to say right now that I really love Magic. I love playing Magic. I've been playing Magic for so long. I put so much time into it. It's a great game. It's such a great game. It's such a great game. And all that I want is to make this game better. Whether I'm right or I'm wrong on the individual things, I feel like I'm pretty spot on in wanting this game to be better. Feeling that we're all on the same team here. We're all working towards the same goals. We all want the same things for Magic. And I just want to give a thank you to everyone who supports me. Thank you to everyone who watches. Thank you to everyone who even gets riled up by my opinions sometimes. And for those of you who see that I'm just one human being that likes magic cards and likes to read and write and talk about it, just want to say thank you so much because I couldn't do it without you. I really couldn't. Or I probably would, but my life would be significantly worse and I would likely be playing quietly in my own room right now, but not broadcasting it for all of y'all. Anyways, back to the match. We're at 12 life, which is on the lower end. We've taken over the board, so that's good. I F6'd, so our Abomination could get lightning bolted. There's a Dragon Fodder and a Legion Loyalist. Oh, and a grenade to the face. Okay. We're at 7. I'm definitely concerned about Goblin Bushwhacker. I'm not really sure the best way to play around it. Best way to play around is probably leave everybody back. Except for the Caribid who has to attack. 3. I guess we're going to be dead to another Goblin Grenade again, because we only have the 3 blockers, take 2, going to 5, and then get grenaded. So bring it on, man. I'm expecting that's what's going to happen, and well, let's see it. Okay, Goblin Guide. Not dead yet. Bushwhacker's a kill. Grenade is a kill. Chieftain is a kill. Chieftain, we're dead. GG's, thanks everyone for watching. I think this deck is great in a GP or Pro Tour type metagame, and I think that I mean it's really all about Blood Moon in the main. If you are expecting a lot of basics from your opponents or a lot of red decks, then I would recommend looking at Restoration Angel or just playing traditional Living End, but I think Blood Moon is a huge haymaker at a Living End. And even though we didn't get to use the sideboard tech, I really believe in that too. So, thanks for watching and peace out. Woo.